Life in the Zambian community of Macha looks very much like a typical rural community in sub-Saharan Africa. Located approximately 70 kilometres from the nearest city, life runs at a slower pace in Macha than in many parts of the world. Families live in simple brick or mud homes. Women cook over open fires. Children pump and carry water by hand, and families survive in large part by subsistence farming. As in many developing countries, one of the most critical challenges Zambians face is poor educational opportunities. UNICEF reports that more than a quarter of a million children in Zambia are out of school, and 47% of those enrolled in school don't complete the primary cycle. In spite of these challenges, one particular school in Macha is significantly improving opportunities for education. Macha International Christian School, or MICS, is a privately run primary school under the leadership of the Brethren in Christ Church of Zambia. Located in the heart of the Macha community, MICS is changing the lives of students and their families. Recognising the need for improved primary education in Macha, local community leaders invited Gil and Rhonda Krauser, an American couple who had been serving at a private school in neighbouring Botswana, to provide leadership to MICS. The vision of MICS is to be a Zambian school with involvement from the international community. It began in 2006 with just 10 students and has experienced significant growth.
MICS today is a primary school with a preschool. We have a three-year-old class, we have a four-year-old reception, which is like kindergarten, and first grade to seventh grade. We have about 130 students, and they're mostly Zambians. Once in a while we have some expat students that come, but it's a Zambian school. The goal of MICS is to provide quality Christian educations to raise Christian leaders for Zambia. And so education done with excellence is what we're striving for. And we're striving to use Zambian teachers to do that. MICS is a primary school that was opened to provide opportunities for children, and the very first thing was computers. It's opportunities, experiences that make things different. MICS has, we're so blessed, we have many games, supplies, puzzles, books. We have a library with 5,000 books in it, and the other schools don't have that. So we can encourage the children to read, we can encourage them to do craft projects. We have been blessed with those types of things. It's, they're learning English. In the government school, they don't start English till later, and they're given the exam in English in grade 7. So these, they're able to communicate, they're able to read, they're encouraged to, like, comprehension, think for themselves.
The differences between MICS and the local government primary schools are significant. Resources, infrastructure, student-to-teacher ratios, and teacher training are all challenges in the government education system. Mr. Bantalian Maplanga is headmaster of nearby Lupata Primary Government School. Knowing firsthand the challenges government schools like his face, Maplanga enrolled his own children at MICS.
The difference between our government schools and the private sector is very big, mainly because our schools here are crowded, are overcrowded, but the private schools, the enrollment is it's very normal. You find a class like at MICS with only maybe 10, 15 children to the maximum. But here, imagine a teacher handling 60 children under one roof is really a challenge. And those are some of the things that actually hinder progress. Slow learners are normally not attended to in our government schools because the teacher just moves at the pace of those that are gifted. Even in terms of resources, it's difficult to provide resources for maybe 60 learners, but where there are maybe 5, 10 learners, it's easy to find resources for them.
Christopher Mulea is another parent of mixed students. As a secondary school teacher, Mulea has an inside understanding of the benefit of MICS.
MICS has resources that are different from government schools. I'll talk of, number one, the textbooks. The school has enough textbooks for students. Each student has their own textbook compared to government schools, where you find a child, maybe 5-10 kids sharing one textbook. Secondly, we'll talk of the infrastructure at MICS. MIX has all the infrastructure, the classrooms and the furniture, the desks that they need. Each child, their own desk. Government schools, maybe one desk, three kids have to share it, which is not very conducive and very good for them. The other resource that MIX has is the human resource, the staff, the teachers, who are qualified. And they have that individualized attention to students compared to government schools. Government schools will have one teacher to about 50, 60 or 70 students.
The quality of education at MIX is having a tangible impact on the students and their ability to progress to secondary school.
When they get to grade 7, they must take a test, grade 7, 9, and 12. They must take a national test, and they have to pass that exam to go on to the next level. So many people stop at grade 7 because they haven't passed the exam. So that is the goal for us, is to pass, for our students to be able to pass so they can get into an excellent secondary school. We don't have enough students in our classes to have our own center number testing site, so we have to sister with another school in Macha. And they test between 90 and maybe 120 students. And both of the years that we tested, our students were the top 5 or 7 students that passed, and probably only 1 or 2 from the government school that we took the exam at passed.
MIX helps them to start reading as far back as maybe preschool, such that when they get to grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, they are able to communicate with many other people in English and be able to read their books and understand what they are reading. Unlike in government schools, kids will just read because they have memorized something and do not understand it or explain it. And eventually, from MIX, the kids who have gone through that, they will excel in their grade 7 exams and even grade 9 exams.
In addition to academic excellence, MIX provides care to children in the community on many levels.
Our main focus is that we're a Christian school and that we have a Christian emphasis. We have devotions every day with the teachers. We have chapel. The children have Bible lessons. Our goal, our real goal, is that children will have a personal relationship with the Lord, and they'll take that out to the community. Our emphasis has also been for orphans and vulnerable children, in that they have no hope. They're in this community as an orphan, staying with anyone the chief has assigned them to, not even family necessarily, but they're also, just there's no hope. The grandmother is a subsistence farmer and has no money or no job, and so we try to get sponsors for these orphans and vulnerable children, and then we have a tithe practice. For every 10 students that God provides at MIX, we invite one student to come free.
We've had children from other schools, but when they come here, they come with a different behavior. So as we teach them, as we help them to know the Lord, they change. So that has really touched the MIX children. And even when they go out in the community, they are the role model. Some, they are coming from families that are not Christians, but because of the children which goes to a Christian school, they've known God.
One of the ways that MIX is reaching out to orphans and vulnerable children is to offer boarding, enabling the staff at MIX to provide a safe and healthy environment for children in need.
Well, all the students actually were walking like 2 hours to get to school in the morning and 2 hours home, and they weren't getting proper food, and they were the ones that had to get up in the morning and work in the field before they came. And so we really thought that it would be good to provide a place for them to have security and food and love and a bed every night during the week when they're studying and having school. They do go home on weekends so that they have a place to call home, to have a family and a place in the community. We're not trying to adopt them, but we are trying to just provide a safe environment for them.
Grade 5 student Hasamba Shamapani was one such student whose life has been impacted.
Asamba is an orphan that came to us. He was living with his aunt and his uncle, and he just didn't seem like he could learn. You'd tell him 25 times and write with him, this is one, this is one, this is one, and he'd repeat it, and then you'd say, okay, you do it, and he couldn't do it. It was amazing. He had a bright smile. He was a charming little boy, but he just didn't seem like he could learn when he first came. And everyone at home, he was the person that had to get up in the morning and do the field work before he came to school, or if there was no food, he wouldn't get breakfast. And that was a reason I started to think, I wonder what would happen if we put him in boarding. I didn't have a scholarship for him, and so I decided I'd find one. And we put him in boarding, and he was just like my first experiment to see what would happen to a child who wasn't functioning well and who was, I knew, was being neglected at home. He was working, he couldn't have time to study, he wasn't getting food, he didn't have a decent place to sleep. So we put him in boarding, and within 6 months, I think, he was speaking English really well. He had started to learn to read, and he could carry on a conversation with us, and he's just progressed since then. He's a polite, nice young man, and it's like he's going to be able to take care of himself, where he never would have been able to do that before.
Asamba, 0 times 10.
0. 6. I really changed my life since when I started running here. I started changing my life. It was bad, but I can see that I'm a changed person. The way that I got here is to be a Christian and how to love one another and to spread the word of the gospel.
Mix is changing the lives of students and families in Macha in significant ways.
One of the differences to make for their future in life from Mix is that when the kids complete from Mix, they'll have their minds opened. They'll have the whole view of what the world is offering outside there, and they'll have an opportunity to go out there and get what they want to get.
Each of the children that come here, we feel like is a success story. They're successful in that they come in and they're village students, and they're not dull. You know, when they're taught and they're able to understand and taught to think, that they become just a success in that.